Okay. Hello, I'm Peter Martin. I'm an architect and a long time, nearly 50 years, resident of Milton Keynes. Take the opportunity to look at fiction, non-fiction, and reference in the gallery setting. Sit down or stand back. We can't do either of those things in its home in the Central Library. There we have to stand on the half landing or glance at it as we negotiate the stairs. Bizarrely, it looks even bigger on the wall here. It rewards a much longer look. And for those of us steeped in the development of Milton Keynes, it brings a sense of nostalgia. It records a time when the city was only 15 or so years from designation and only into 10 to 12 years of serious construction. However old we are now, we and the city were so much younger then. Fionnuala Boyd and Les Evans were invited to Milton Keynes by the Development Corporation in 1980 to make a big picture for the Woofton Centre, then a leisure centre. They explored the town on bikes using their by now usual technique of taking lots of photographs that they would subsequently chop up, arrange, and use as the basis for the painting. It was a method of working that they had developed on their year-long road trip to the United States in the late 70s. The painting they made, Situation Comedy, 1981, now hangs in the Central Library and shows a corner of Netherfield housing, a typical Milton Keynes underpass, a number of figures, including their daughter Ruby, glimpses into private lives and steps inside the Woofton Centre. They asked the corporation if they could have a residency. A sequence of community artists were employed by the corporation in the early years to give another dimension to the development of the growing community. Liz Lay was employed between 74 and 78, and amongst other things made the now iconic Concrete Cows in 1978 as a summer project with school kids. Bill Billings was the community artist from 78 to 80 and made the Triceratops at Pear Tree Bridge in 79 and many other things then and subsequently. Leslie Bonner, Stephen Gregory were both community artists in the late 70s and Jack Trevor Story was a writer in residence. They, the artists, would also work with schools. Boyd and Evans stayed on the understanding they would make an artwork. They moved into Stacey Hill Farmhouse, now part of the Milton Keynes Museum, and set about looking for a site for the work. They wanted it to be site-specific. They spent more time gathering material, taking photographs of people and places, and sketching ideas of how it would work. They discovered early on that the work would be an amalgamation of many things, not just one scene. They were ultimately invited to look at a location in the then unfinished Central Library. The painting mixes fictional with real events, people and places. They play with perspective and scale, but buildings and places are all recognisable if relationships aren't, but are accurately depicted and precisely painted. The painting is on 12 panels and they had never seen it all together until it was hung. From the way they show the hectic pace of constructing a new town, they reference the serenity of Georges Seurat's Bathers at Asnières, painted a century before in 1884, showing workers from the factories of Clichy relaxing beside the Seine. Boyd and Evans replaced the figures with their own images at the same scale and in similar poses. The dog is an exact copy. The working title of the painting had been 1984, but they decided that that offered a loaded judgment for a new town, a year, of course, hijacked by George Orwell. So they painted Arthur Scargill and Margaret Thatcher, thus dating it to the miners' strike. Other clues are the clothes, Casio watches, the waving workers in Lloyd's Court, and the red balloons. If you do visit the Central Library to see their other early commissioned work, Situation Comedy, relocated from Woofton and someday from 1984, you will also see a number of their other pieces that have been hung there to fill the space left by fiction, non-fiction and reference. Well worth a visit while the exhibition is on.